everyone. I am Dr. Amit Kumar, faculty of MBA department from Technia Institute of Advanced Studies. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on objective and scope of SMEs in economic development of India. For a country to grow, the government should actively promote business enterprises. Among business enterprises, the micro, small and medium enterprises deserve special attention. Though MSMEs are small investment enterprises, but their contribution to the Indian economy is very significant. Objectives and scopes of MSMEs in India. First, to generate large-scale employment. In India, capital is scarce and labor is abundant. MSMEs are thought to have lower capital output and capital labor ratios than large-scale industries, and therefore better serve growth and employment objectives. The MSME sector in India has grown significantly since 1960, with an average annual growth rate of 4.4% in the number of units and 4.62% in employment, currently employing 30 million. Not only do MSMEs generate the highest employment per capita investment, they also go a long way in checking rural-urban migration by providing people living in isolated areas with a sustainable source of employment. Next, to sustain economic growth and increase exports. Non-traditional products account for more than 95% of the MSME's exports, dominating in the export of sports goods, ready-made garments, plastic products, etc. Since these products are mostly handcrafted and hence eco-friendly, there exists a tremendous potential to expand the quantum of MSME-led exports. Next, ancillary to large-scale industry. MSMEs act as ancillary industries for large-scale industries, providing them with raw materials, vital components, and backward linkages. For example, large-scale cycle manufacturers of Ludhiana rely heavily on the MSMEs of Malle Kotla with product cycle parts. Malle Kotla, which produce cycle parts. Manufacturers of Ludhiana rely heavily on the MSMEs of Malle Kotla, which produce cycle parts. Next, making growth inclusive. MSMEs are instruments of inclusive growth, which touch upon the lives of the most vulnerable and marginalized. For many families, it is the only source of livelihood. Thus, instead of taking a welfare approach, this sector seeks to empower people to break the cycle of poverty and deprivation. It focuses on people's skills and agency. However, different segments of the SME sector are dominated by different social groups. Next, it creates large-scale employment. Enterprises that are inclusive in this sector require low capital to start up new business. Moreover, it creates a vast opportunity for the unemployed people to avail. India produces about 1.2 million graduates per year, out of which the total number of engineers are around 0.8 million. There is no economy so far that could provide the large number of freshers in 1 year only. MSME is the boom for the fresh talent in India. Next scope is to leverage exports. It is the most significant driver in India, contributing to the tune of 8% to GDP. Considering the contribution of MSMEs to manufacturing exports and employment, other sectors are also benefiting from it. Nowadays, MNCs are buying semi-finished and auxiliary products from small enterprises. For example, buying of clutches and brakes by automobile companies, it is helpful in creating a linkage between MSME and big companies even after the implementation of the GST. 40% MSME sector also applied GST registration that plays an important role to increase the government revenue by 11%. Next scope is to utilize cheap labor. While in the large scale organization, one of the main challenges is to retain the human resource through an effective human resource management professional. But when it comes to MSME, the requirement of labor is less and it does not need a highly skilled labor. Therefore, the direct expenses incurred by the owner is also low. So, I hope you must have understood the topic, objective and scope of SMEs in economic development of India. Thank you very much.